How to decode marking on this transistor? How to find its part number? How to find its datasheet? This is a question from my viewer. In my last video, I shared a short video how to decode this transistor, and I shared a screenshot from smdyooneed.one. But my viewer asked, I have a question about your short video labeled Decode SMD Transistor Marking 3F. How did you arrive to get part number BC857B from marking 3F? I am your host Muhammad Ashraf, and I welcome you on my YouTube channel. Let's decode this SMD component. Decoding SMD component, finding its part number, especially when we are working on any device, any equipment, and we have damaged SMD component, how to find its part number and how to find equivalent for that component, because this marking will not give any clue to equivalent. But when we will find part number, then we can find equivalent, substitute, we can find replacement. I never say to watch full video, but if you want to understand the complete process, I will suggest to watch this video without skipping any portion, so that you will take benefit from each frame of the video, because I will demonstrate step by step practically. To decode any SMD component, the very basic parameter, first requirement, SMD marking, SMD code, 3F. Then there is T and 02. Sometimes some manufacturer use this small letter to indicate the location, factory location. Sometime it is batch number, sometime it is date code. We will see it. Second requirement, component ID. In our case, component ID is Q. That means it is transistor or MOSFET. If U, that means it is IC. If D, diode. Number of pins, 3. Then dimensions. Length, width, height, thickness in millimeter, 2.92. Now we'll need width, 1.35 millimeter. We will not measure thickness now or height now. These two measurements will enough. Some manufacturer will use this dimension, and some will use terminal to terminal measurement in width. To take the measurement from terminal to terminal, we need to desolder it. We need to clean it, remove all excessive solder to take exact measurements. Now we have 2.9 millimeter by 1.3 millimeter. Here we have different tools. I will share the links in the video description. You can download these documents. These are very useful while decoding SMD components. The first, Nexperia semiconductor poster. In the left side, there are number of pins. 2 pin, 3 pin. In our case, we have 3 pin component. In 3 pin components row, we will locate our measurement, that is 2.9 millimeter by 1.3 millimeter. Yes, we have this measurement, 2.9 millimeter by 1.3 millimeter by 1 millimeter. 2.9 millimeter length, 1.3 millimeter width, and 1 millimeter height. It is SOT23. Some manufacturers write SOT23 and some of them write SOT-23. We completed first step. The second step, cross-reference for this size code. Why we need cross-reference? Let's suppose this size code from Nexperia. The same measurement, maybe from ROHM or any other component, National Semiconductor, MCC, TI, whatsoever. Other manufacturers will give other names to these dimensions. We need to check the size code from that manufacturer's, that is cross-reference. Maybe Philips, Nexperia is not making this component with this code. 3F is available with other package codes. So we need to confirm the other package codes as well. For that purpose, we will check cross-reference chart. Size code or package code cross-reference. At row number 18, we have SOT23 package. Maybe some other manufacturer is giving SC59. SC59. SOT346. That is also industrial name. Then other name TO236AB. TO236AB. SMT3. Then MPAK. Mini3-G3-B. CPH3. We can also check different selection charts. If we check Toshiba discrete device package lineups, here are SMD components and measurements. Yes, we have SOT23 here. Here we have two type measurements, 2.9 mm length, 1.3 mm width. And here is also terminal to terminal, that is 2.4 mm. Terminal thickness, terminal pitch, what is the distance between center of one pin and center of second pin? What is the total height? We can see here SOT23, SOT-23. And we have 2.9 by 2.4 mm, 2.9 mm length, 2.4 mm width. That is including terminal to terminal measurements. Length, width, terminal to terminal width, pitch, center of one pin to center of second pin, terminal thickness, height. All measurements are mentioned here. Then we can check this MCC. Yes, SOT23. In this SOT23 package, a very detailed measurements are mentioned here. Measurement A, that is body width, in inches and in millimeter. Now in this package, if we see the body length, maybe from 2.8 mm to 3.04 mm. Body width may be 1.2 to 1.4 mm. Here we have central semiconductor. Here is SOT23. If the length is 3.05, width is 2.49 and height is maximum 1.09, that is SOT-23 package. The same which we are discussing. Same here, ROHM. This is SOT-23 measurements and its name in ROHM is SSD3. We can use any database, any datasheet tool, any decoding website. First we will ask from Google, 3F SMD transistor in SOT-23 package. The first website, DC857. PNP SMD transistor SOT23. Then 3F SMD transistor BC857 SOT23. S-dash manuals. Marking of electronic component SMD codes 3F. BC857B. ST components. BC857 3F3E 3F3G. Now we will see smdyooneed.one. We will locate 3F in this table, this one. Now we need this 3F marking in any one of these package codes. Here is 3F marking SOT23, BC857B, SOT23, STS Thompson, PNP transistor, part number BC857B. General purpose transistor 50 volt, 100 milliampere, 310 milliwatt. BC857 datasheet. That is this one. This one. We will open it. PNP transistor BC857. BC857 3H marking. 857A 3E marking. 875B 3F marking. 857C 3G marking. In our case, marking is 3F. That means it is BC857B. 3FT. BC857B. We have fixed T. T means made in Malaysia. After 3F, we have T. This T means made in Malaysia. The difference in these transistors, gain. BC857B gain from 220 to 475 maximum. Gain ratio between base current and collector current. How much base current we will apply at base, how much current we will receive at collector. That ratio is called HFE or gain. We apply 1 milliampere at base, we receive 400 milliampere at collector. That means the gain is 400. 400 milliampere collector current divided by base current. If we have 400 milliampere, in case we apply 1 milliampere at base, 400 divided by 1, 400 gained. Now we will check alldatasheet.com. Select here marking. Type here 3F. 3F, it is Schottky diode. Then 3F SOT323 low power rectifier. BC857BLT1G SOT23 general purpose transistor. Let's check this one. Marking and package codes are matching with our requirement. Let's check it. BC856, 857, 858, 859S. Here is marking scheme. 3F marking for BC857B transistor. SOT23, 3F marking. Now we'll check smdmark.com. 3F. 3F857B. Now we can check s-manuals.com. Locate 3F here. 3FT SOT23, that is exactly our required component. So all these 3F series, 3FP, 3FS, 3FT, 3FW, all are same. Yes, we have this datasheet from NXP, from Philips. That is this 3F marking. BC857BW, made in Malaysia, T for made in Malaysia. Pin 1 base, pin 2 emitter, pin 3 collector. Pin 1, 2, 3 base, emitter, collector. We checked cross reference, we checked part number, we checked data sheet. Now we will test it. Set multimeter to diode. Because it is PNP, base is negative and common is N, negative type, so PNP 0.743 0.738, low reading between base to collector, more reading between base to emitter. Reverse the leads. Open circuit, open circuit. If we find some high reading between base to emitter or base to collector, that will due to external components. So this transistor is good. If you enjoyed this decoding, give a thumb up. If you have not subscribed my channel until now, you can subscribe it. You can share with your friends. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.